Good evening. My name is Carol Hansen, and I'm a Pigeon Falls Lions. And we're going to start the variety show after 2 years being gone. I'm very, very happy to be here. Right up front, thank you to all the performers that make this possible. At this time, I want to recognize our veterans that are here this evening. So when I call your name, please stand and stay standing until all of the veterans have been recognized. Dave Olson, U.S. Navy, 1975 to 84. Steve Akinek, U.S. Army, 84 to 86. It's okay to look around so we see these young gentlemen. Thomas Watt, U.S. Army, 1970 to 72. Doug England, U.S. Air Force, 1960 to 1982. Jim Klumstein, U.S. Army, 1970 to 72. Randy Staff, U.S. Army, 1968 to 70. Did I miss anyone? If not, let's give these gentlemen a round of applause and tell them thank you for their service. The Pigeon Flyers 4-H group had a reunion this afternoon, and we are very happy some were willing to stay tonight and sing for the variety show. I was from Hale and Hardy, and Pigeon Flyers and Hale and Hardy, let's just say we were challenged each other. And I remember Pigeon Flyers was very, very good in all their musical selections. So the Pigeon Flyer alumni members, come on up. They're going to sing three songs. They're going to sing, as they're coming up, I'll introduce the songs. I'm a 4-H member. This land is your land. And let there be peace on earth. Pigeon Flyers, come on up to the microphones.
I'm a 4-H member with PTA. I like to work and I like to play. I use my head to think things through and pledge my heart forever to be true. I use my hands to serve mankind and to my health each day. Put them together and you'll hear me say, I'm a 4-H member today.
Like a little louder accompaniment to balance our voices.
For audience
participation.
Yeah. Everybody now.
Yeah, all together.
Let there be peace on earth.
And that was without any practicing. That's pretty darn good. Thank you very, very much. Brings back a lot of memories. The Johnson girls from Big Slough are back, and we welcome them. Nadine Kukar is a nurse and lives near Galesville, and Ruby Kirkman is a speech therapist at West Salem Elementary School and lives in Bangor. We're very glad they're here, and they're going to sing Blowing in the Wind. Thank you very much, Nadine and Ruby. At this time, Caden Geyer will come up. He's going to be a senior this fall at Whitehall High School. He is a member of the Chamber Choir and will be attending Honors Choir this summer and performing in Madison in October. He earned a perfect score at State for his vocal solo. His solo this evening is called Empty Chairs. His accompanist is Richard Staff.
So a brief summary of the song is it takes place shortly after the French Revolution, and our main character, Marius, has just lost almost all his friends. And in the presence of this song, he's at the cafe where he used to always sing and be with his friends and talk about overthrowing the government. But now they're dead after the war.
There's a grief that can't be spoken. There's a pain goes on and on. empty chairs at empty tables. Now my friends are dead and gone. Here they talked of revolution. Here it was they lit the flame. Here they sang about tomorrow. And tomorrow never came. From the table in the corner, they could see a world reborn. And they rose with voices ringing, and I can hear them now, the very words that they had sung became the last communion on the lonely barricade at dawn. Oh, my friends, forgive me that I live and you are gone. There's a grief that can't be spoken. There's a pain goes on and on. Phantom faces at the window. Phantom shadows on the floor. Empty chairs at empty tables, where my friends will meet no more. Oh, my friends, don't ask me what your sacrifice was for. Empty chairs at empty tables, where my friends will sing no
Wow. Good job, Kaiden. That's excellent. Emerson Stay, come on up. Emerson is 10 years old and will be in the fifth grade next year. She enjoys playing piano, playing volleyball, and hanging out with her friends. A special shout out to one of our youngest performers. Her parents are Sandra and Jason Stay. She's going to play When the Saints Go Marching In and Celebration. Welcome, Emerson. Great job, Emerson. Eric Ringling is going to do a reading of some self-written poetry. The name of it is Ghosts of Eckern Park. Eric said just to introduce him and he'll do the rest. But I want to say that he has two cute granddaughters, Sophie and Natalie.
I guess once you retire, you get a chance to like have your brain actually slow down and you can think. So this is kind of some of the thoughts that come in my head. This is called The Ghosts of Eckern Park. Excuse me. Yeah, I'll get that. Cheaters first, sorry. Otherwise, maybe Richard could hold it and I could read it. Lower your eyelids and come with me as we stroll through our memories. Yes, so yes, here they come out of the dark, the ghosts of Eckern Park. You could see them, I know you do. Sitting and walking two by two. On the hill, it's Ann and Bill and Addison and Amy. The butcher Gelsted and that Rugsted from York, they're here already. So many faces, I can't begin to name them all. So many spirits have answered the call. There's Olga and Oscar, and Agnes and Joe, and Melford and Mary. The Knudsens, the Thorsons, the Hagens and Hansons, Arthur and Harry. There's Esther and Newland and Julia and Wilhelm and Zelpha and Benny. And all the Johnsteds and Klumpsteins too. Oh, and there sits Helma and Knut. Yep, for sure, there, yep, sure enough, there goes Theron and Anna Ruth. Here's Arnie and Vic, and in the food stand, Dolores and Dick and Dorothea have come to join the host. And then there's Reynolds, he's not yet a ghost. Here comes Thurman and Freddy and Vernon and Kitty with Hank and Esther looking so pretty. Clark and Gloria selling Tootsie Rolls 10 for a penny. Hey, look over there, it's Neppy and Kenny. And out of the dark comes Roger and Marty and Dale making that chicken we love so well. Harriet and Harold and Leona and Clark stand at ready, they've found their marks. Eleanor and Howard and Donald and Irene, and then a bunch of little leaguers making the scene. And around the corner, here comes Ray, like his brethren, dressed in yellow vest and matching hat, ready for today. For today is their day. It's Memorial Day. Down at the store, the high school marching band is ready in full uniform. Woolen and heavy, epaulette shoulders and feathered hats, sharp pressed trousers and bleach white spats, followed by the scouts and the 4-H. Hoping to keep their line straight, they march up the street past the creamery and the school. They're a part of this story, they're ghosts too. A majorette's whistle blows the cadence, drummers on the rims at the entrance. This was done for tradition, honor, and reverence. Down the hill and across the field, they take their place. Our anthem is sung, then a prayer for grace. Myrtle chords out the battle hymn. They join in, because they know it just like that. A reading of the address, another song, a lengthy speech. The auxiliary moves forward, place a wreath. The flag is lowered. They bow their heads as Henry reads the roll of the dead. Names they hear year after year. Yet still evoke a tender tear. Three times the rifles sound. Then a distant bugler's call. The program is over. Now let's play ball. It is here now, friends, that my journey ends, and I'd like to thank you But I challenge you folks that are younger than me, look up from those handheld TVs. Study our faces, learn our names, and remember our places. For one day, we too will take our marks and join the ghosts of Eckern Park. Thank you.
Thank you, Eric. Next, Nora Bergerson will play or sing a vocal solo, and the name of it is I'd Give My Life for You from Miss Saigon. Nora is the daughter of Ryan and Amy Bergerson and will be a senior this fall in Whitehall. She's also an excellent gymnast. She'll be performing her Broadway solo from the Solo and Ensemble Contest. Nora.
All right, so just to give a little background for the song. So following the Vietnam War, my character Kim sings of her devotion to her son in the song, which is the finale of Act One. She and her son then set out on ships with other refugees headed for America.
You who I cradled in my arms, you asking as little as you can. Little snip of a little man. I know I give my life for you. You didn't ask me to be born, you. Why should you learn of war or pain? To make sure you're not hurt again, I swear I'll give my life for you. I've tasted love beyond all fear, and you should know it's love that brought you here. And in one perfect night, when the stars burn like new, I knew what I must do. I'll give you a million things I'll never own. I'll give you a world to conquer when you're grown. You will be who you want to be. You can choose whatever heaven grants. As long as you can have your chance, I swear I'll give my life for you. Sometimes I wake up reaching for him. I feel my shadow brush my head, but there's just moonlight on my bed. Was he a ghost? Was he a lie that made my body laugh and cry? Then by my side, the proof I see, his little one, God's of the sun, bring him to me. You will be who you want to be. You can choose whatever heaven grants. As long as you can have your chance, I swear I'll give my life for you. No one can stop what I must do. I swear I'll give my life for you.
Thank you, Nora. Nice job. Cheyenne Thompson is going to have a violin solo called Minuet 3. Cheyenne's parents are Melissa and Peter Thompson, and she is 12 years old. Cheyenne enjoys playing violin, saxophone, and softball. a little bit about the violin she is playing. It was rebuilt, and it was originally Cheyenne's great-great-grandfather's, and it came from Norway, and was originally made around 1900. So it's a very, very special violin to the Thompson family. Cheyenne. Very good, Cheyenne. Thank you. Next, we're going to have a vocal duet by Ariana Ostrow and Carly Molis. Ariana will be entering high school, and Carly is going to be an eighth grader. They both participated in solo and ensemble contests, and both enjoy sports. Ariana's parents are Christoph and Nikki Ostrow, and Carly's parents are Jason and Melissa Molis. They are going to sing Sing with Joy. And we are encouraging them to get close enough to the mics when they're practicing. They have beautiful voices, so I hope you can hear them.
Joy.
Very good job, girls. At this time, we're going to have the Norse Bucketeers come on up. David Akinick, Gage Smith, Riley Vollard, and Brenna Wicca. And their director is Deidre Meyer. They're going to do Thunder by Imagine Dragons, and they're going to play Buckets. I'm so excited. I've been waiting for years to have some bucket players. Deidre Meyer is an elementary music teacher in Whitehall and will direct the group this evening. She and her husband have a house right here in Pigeon Falls. The four students are seventh grade students now, and I attended their sixth grade graduation this past week. Looks like they had a great time at the school forest, or the school campout, I guess it's called in Whitehall. Thanks for participating, seventh graders.
Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer. Take a number, I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder, thunder.
Classes while I was scheming for the masses. Who do you think you are? Dreaming about being a big star. They say you're basic, they say you're easy. You're always riding in the backseat. Now I'm smiling from the stage while you were clapping in the nosebleeds.
Good job, David, Gage, Riley, and Brennan. Next, we are going to have Stuart and Phoenix Neal, and they're going to do a solo and a ukulele accompanist, and they're going to sing, or she's going to sing Rainbow Connection. Mr. Neal is the band director in Whitehall, and Phoenix is a nurse at Tri-County Hospital. They moved here from Jackson, Mississippi in 2019. They have two children, Autumn, age 6, and Judah, age 2. Welcome.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows and what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions, and rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it. I know they're wrong, wait and see. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. Who said that every wish would be heard and answered when wished on the morning star? Somebody thought of that, and someone believed it. Look how it's come so far. What's so amazing that keeps us stargazing? And what do we think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. All of us under its spell, we know that it's probably magic. Have you been half asleep? And have you heard voices? I've heard them calling my name. Is this the sweet song that calls the young sailors? The voice might be one and the same. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something that I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. La da da dee da da dum, la da 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 dee da da dum.
Very nice. Thank you very, very much. At this time, Goody Ringling's gonna come up. And Goody used to be on a lot of variety shows back in the days when my dad did this. And my dad would call her up on Saturday and say, Goody, can you do something for the variety show? And so Goody would come and make all of us laugh many, many minutes. She told me she never has a title for any of her talks. So I said, well, I can't just leave it empty. So she agreed for me to put it on Memories. And she came out of retirement, and I'm very glad she did. She's married to Kenny, and I think she's been a member here at the church for her whole life. 85 years. So Goody Ringling in her brand new outfit, bought at Dayton's a couple years ago. Goody Ringling.
Yeah, I don't know how this is going to go, but anyway. Carol called and asked what my title was. Title? I said, I'm not buying land or anything. I don't have a title. Well, she said, you have to have a heading or something, a name. Oh, I said, just put anything down. Yeah, this was on maybe Tuesday night, and I hadn't thought about what I was going to do yet. Well, anyway, memories of Pigeon Falls. Well, that could last most of the night, you know. Well, so then last night after supper, I thought I better go upstairs and storeroom and see if I can find my dress. Well, I found the dress, but I couldn't even get my sleeves in it. Oof, that's tough to get old and get these flabby arms, you know. Well, anyway, I suppose I should have been exercising all these years. But, you know, I went to an exercise class and, well, it was over before I got my leotards on, so I thought, to heck with it, just be the way you are. So I think of the memories of Pigeon Falls. Ugh. I think of Donald, living right in the center of Pigeon, you know, in the B.M. Sletland house, you know. And you could call him anytime, day or night, 5551. And except I can't help but tell this again. When our combine was burning up at Dennis's, Dennis Johnson borrowed our combine and caught fire, of course, and we saw the smoke, so we went up there, and here stands Kenneth in the middle of the of the driveway. And Kenny said, "Did you call the fire department?" "Well, yeah," he said, I couldn't remember that 9-something number, so I just called Donald Ackley." And we heard the fire truck come. Anyway, well then, you know, any time of day or night you call Donald Ackley. And one night he got up and 3 o'clock in the morning answered the phone. And, oh, the guy said, "I apologize, it's the wrong number." "Oh, don't worry," Donald said, "I had to get up and answer the phone anyway." Oh, yeah. And then, of course, around Memorial Day, it was always Donald and Arnie's birthday. Of course, Arnie, he hardly ever got off the farm. He got to town once in a while. Anyway, he always told when he was dating Victoria, you know. He went out one night, and they went out, and when he came home, his dad was still up. And he said, "You went out with that Hardy's Creek girl again?" "Yeah," he said. "Well," he said, "it looks like the evening must have cost quite a bit to be out this late." "No, 25 cents, Arnie said. 25 cents? Yeah, that's all she had." Leave it to Arnie. Well, and then, of course, the price of gas has gone up, you know, and everybody's complaining about that. Well, I never thought too much about it. I've put $5 worth on regardless. Anyway, Ray Hagen, you know, he sold cars, and he sold a new one to Theron Paulson. He said to Theron one day, "Well, what's the gas mileage on that car?" "Well," Theron said, "I get 5 cents and the boys get 20. In other words, the boys use the car most of the time. Well, you know, talk about gas prices and cars. You know, I lived in Tuffcoole all my life, and Howard Ackley lived on the high end of Tuffcoole, and, you know, he drove so darn fast that if I saw him come out of the driveway up on the other upper end, I didn't dare cross the road to get the mail, because he would be there in little time or no. Oh, yeah. Say, how's Hooskaloo's road been this year? Has it been pretty good? Well, you know, Eric was telling that it was so darn muddy, of course, that he had to get out and pull people out of the ditch and out of the mud all the time. And one day a city slicker from Foster came, and he got stuck in the mud, so Eric pulled him out, of course. And he got out, and Eric charged him $5. "Oh," he said, "boy, at prices like that, you should be pulling him out night and day." "Can't," Eric said. "In the evening, I have to haul water for the holes." Oh, yeah. Then, memories of Pigeon. Oh, the nursing home came. We didn't have a nursing home for a long time, but it's a good thing to have, of course, because that's where all, evidently all of land. Anyway, they called me up and they were going to have a program. Can you do something? Yeah, something. I can do something. And, well, we can send you a brochure. Oh, heck, I said, don't bother. I don't even wear one. I learned that long time ago. If you did, it draws the wrinkles out of your face. So if you look around and see if these women don't have any wrinkles, well, don't wear no brochure. Dale Fremstead, he's up at the nursing home now. He had his birthday around this time, too. And, of course, he sold machinery and everything, and he was really pretty good, you know, at it. And once a year, they had a sale on manure spreaders, and 50% off. And the best part of it was he stood behind. Well, of course, we got this woman, this Swede, as for a minister now, and she's going to leave. And she got the Pigeon, and she went out in the driveway out here, and she's going to look around. She's going to go to the post office. But she didn't know where it was. And here comes Carl Overby up the street, and pretty slow, you know. And she stopped him and introduced herself that she was the new minister in the church. And he says, you know, he didn't say much. And I'm looking for the post office, she said. Oh, he said, yeah, she said, but would you come and listen to me preach? I'm going to preach about how to get to heaven. Oh, Carl said, no way, I don't think so. You don't even know the way to the post office. So now then, she'll be sitting up north. She says, in a little house, I suppose, and drinking coffee. Oh my God, she drinks coffee. And she has bad eyes. And she said, it feels like there's something stabbing in there. I said, yeah, well, take the spoon out of your cup. Oh, bad. Well, then you all remember the storm of 2001 when Richard Erickson's house roof was laying on 121 and everybody's shingles were flying and we couldn't get home from the Kathy's birthday and, oh my gosh. Well, anyway, there's plenty to do after that storm, you know. Well, then Dale Hangartner and Tom Danziger had a lot of work to do. And they were putting siding on a house one day, and Dale noticed that Danziger was throwing some nails on the ground. What's up with that? Dale said. Well, Tom said, the head is on the wrong end. Oh, not to worry, Dale said. We'll use them for the other side of the house. Oh, yeah, they were quite a pair. Well, about like when Reynolds and Hank Jacobson and Harry Gelston went to a lodge meeting. And they had a monthly drawing, you know, and of course they'd never won, never. Well, by golly, Hank took first place. He got 2 pounds of spaghetti sauce, and he got 4 boxes of noodles, and 3 pounds of false balls. And Harry, he got a round trip to Duluth to hear the Inger Triplets band. See, I can't talk either. And Reynolds got third prize. He got a toilet brush. So then, of course, they came home and they had their monthly meeting and everything, and they see how that went with their prices. Well, Hank said, you know, that spaghetti, it lasted for 3 days. It was really good. We didn't have to spend much on groceries Well, that was good. I'm sure Hank enjoyed that. You have to know these people to know that. And Harry said, yeah, that was a nice trip. He said, we took the Greyhound. We got on down at the restaurant. We went to Duluth and even had a outhouse in the bus. And we got up there and we heard those triplets singing. And if I wouldn't have been, I thought they all looked like sisters. Well, yeah, they were triplets. Well, they said to Reynolds, so how did your toilet brush work? Oh, yeah, he said, it worked, but I think I'm going to go back to paper. But anyway, Reynolds is still smiling. And, you know, once he went to a golf meeting, and it was all young girls there, you know, and he came home and he said to Dorothy, you know, he said, at that meeting, all those girls were smiling at me. Well, she said, that's nothing. I laughed out loud the first time I saw you. Oh, yeah. And how many of you remember Dockey? Oh, yeah, Dockey and Wendell Hagen. They were always up to something. Well, one time they even put Dockey in a casket. It's a long story, but anyway. They decided they were going to take a trip too, and they got on the bus and they went to Minneapolis. And of course, both of them were so darn tight. They took their own food, and they started eating. And pretty soon, Dockey said to Wendell, "Have you eaten your banana yet?" "No," he said. "Well, don't," he said. "I just took a bite of mine and I went blind. They went through the tunnel." And so that was it. And comes Memorial Day, you can't help but think about the baseball season starting. And Irene Nepperd said, you know, she said, "Neppy, he hardly sleeps during the baseball season because he dreams about he's losing his turn at bat." I think Mike Liga might have done that too. Anyway, I gotta make it short. So have a good Memorial Day. And now, I probably won't do this anymore, but by golly, I think my son might keep doing this. And I thought, I gotta leave a thought for today. And I thought, if you can't have everything you want, you just make the best of everything you got. Thank you.
I do want the kids that are here to know that Goody usually doesn't dress like that. That is her costume. Thank you, Goody. At this time, Olivia Hayes is going to play her violin. She's going to play the song called Sun. Olivia is finishing seventh grade this spring in Chippewa Falls Middle School. She enjoys drawing, playing soccer and basketball, and loves to help in the kitchen. She's the daughter of Travis Hayes and girlfriend Julie. Olivia Hayes.
Thank you.
Nice job, Olivia. At this time, Bethany Ringling Dano is going to do a vocal solo. Her accompanist is her uncle, Richard Staff. She's going to sing Fathers and Daughters. Bethany lives outside of Independence is the calf boss on the Dano farms. A quote from Bethany, "No matter where life takes me, Pigeon Falls will always be my home." Fathers and Daughters by Bethany Dano.
Well, you laughed and told me you really wanted a boy. But you cried first time you held me, said you never felt such joy. That's fathers and daughters. When you took the train and wheels right off my bike, that's the first time I could feel my wings, 'cause you taught me I could fly. That's fathers and daughters. When I was a pink ballerina dancing in the kitchen, you held out your hand so I could try my luck at spinning. The world keeps turning, always through it all, I knew you would catch me when I start to fall. That's fathers and daughters. When you let me go out on my first date, you waited up and you didn't tell Mom, even though I got home late. That's fathers and daughters. And one day when that boy made my heart break, you told me that's why God made tears, to wash the hurt away. And I'm still that pink ballerina dancing in the kitchen. You hold out your hand, I go right back to the beginning. The world keeps turning, always through it all, you're still there to catch me, I'm still learning how to fall. That's fathers and daughters, like roses and water. We grow up and discover no one ever loves each other like father and daughter.
Thank you, Bethany. Good job. At this time, Lucy Peterson is going to do a reading. Lucy is the daughter of Betsy and Ryan, and she's 8 years old and the youngest on our program tonight. She loves basketball and softball. She enjoys math and can be found dancing and singing or writing in her free time, and has a younger sister, Lila. Lucy Peterson reading Be You by Peter Reynolds.
Many things. My wish for you, no matter where your journey leads, is for you to always be you. Be ready to take that next step toward being an amazing human being. Be curious. Turn every stone, ask every why, and keep digging deeply. Discover your own answers. Be persistent. keep going, never stop. Keep going, never stop. Keep going, never stop. Be different, be silly, be quirky, be odd, be unique, be weird, be colorful, be okay with being different, be just the way you are. Be kind, be understanding, help those around you to listen to themselves. Listen, then listen some more. Learn more about who they are. Be brave, try new things, take a deep breath, and plunge forward into new experiences. It gets easier every time you try. Be your own thinker. Think for yourself and set your own unique course. It isn't always easy, but you will be heading in the direction of you. Be okay being alone. Take time to be on your own. Hear your own thoughts, your inner voice. Listen to your heart. Be patient. Being more you takes time. Take a deep breath. Relax. Let your future unfold at its own pace. It will be worth the wait. Be okay reaching out for help. When you need a helping hand, a compassionate ear, and encouraging word, reach out. As you voyage out into the world, remember, no matter what, you will always be loved. You are ready, so go ahead. Be you. Be very, very you.
How many of you would dare read like that when you were 8 years old? Good job, Lucy. At this time, Ariel and Alexa Coxling are going to sing a vocal duet. The name of their song is Traveling Soldier by the Chicks. These two sisters love to sing together, and they have been singing together for years. Ariel is a student at UW-La Crosse, and Alexa just graduated from high school. Both sisters are pursuing careers in teaching elementary students. Their parents are Courtney and Brian Coxling. I'm also proud to announce they are both awarded the Lions Scholarship their senior year in high school.
Ariel and Alexa. I am better. I'm better, just so you all know, I am better.
Bus in his army green, sat down in a booth at a cafe. There gave his order to a girl with a bow in her hair. He's a little shy, so she gives him a smile, and he said, would you mind sitting down for a while and talking to me? I'm feeling a little low. She said, I'm off in an hour and I know where we can go. So they went down and they sat on the pier. He said, I bet you got a boyfriend, but I don't care. I got no one to send a letter to. Would you mind if I sent one back here to you? So scared of, he's said when it's getting kind of rough over here, I think of that day sitting down at the pier, and I close my eyes and see her pretty smile. Don't worry, but I won't be able to write for a while. I cry, never gonna hold the hand of another guy. Too young for him, makes older. Waiting for the love of a traveling soldier. Our love will never end. Waiting for the soldier to come back again. Even more to be alone when the letter says the soldier's coming. Said in the anthem, sang a man, said, folks, would you bow your head for a list of local Vietnam dead? Crying all alone under the stands was a piccolo player in the marching band, and one named Red, but nobody really cared. But a pretty little girl with a bow in her.
Nice job, girls. How many times do you think I've had you sing at the variety show?
Too many.
Oh, no, no. It's nice to see the kids growing up. They start younger and help us out two or three times. John Skaug is going to do a trumpet solo. He's accompanied by his sister, Jackie Goplin. He's going to March Militaire by Frank Schubert, arranged by David Schaffer. John and his wife, Connie, retired and moved to Windy Ridge, north of Pigeon Falls, in 2019. They have three children living in Madison, Portland, Oregon, and Fort Worth, Texas, and two granddaughters, but did you get another new grand? Third grandbaby this week, I think, right? Just Monday. So Jackie is his sister, and she'll be accompanying him, and he'll be singing or playing March Militaire. Is that right?
And I just want to know, this is what happens when you meet Carol walking out of Sunday worship.
I needed another instrumental adult, so you're it.
Thank you.
Thank you, John. At this time, I'd like to thank Richard and Jackie and have everybody give them a round of applause for playing and accompanying these people. At this time, Eric and Julie Goplin will be singing a vocal duet, their father and daughter, if you do not know that. They're going to sing A Whole New World. Eric became a grandpa of Orland and Erling since the last time he sang at the variety show. He still looks pretty good. Julie is a daughter of Eric and Jackie and is a chiropractor in Eau Claire. Their accompanist is Jackie Goplin, and they are singing again, A Whole New World.
We shouldn't be last. I should be home hauling water.
Eric wants me to tell a joke. Well, Eric, he's having troubles with his microphone here. I don't have any jokes. I could call Goody up. She's always got an extra one. Are you ready now, Eric?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now, when did you last? Let your heart decide. I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under, on a magic carpet ride. A whole new world, a new fantastic point of view. No one can tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming. Now I'm in a whole new world with you.
Unbelievable sights, indescribable feeling, soaring, tumbling, freewheeling through an endless time and sky. A whole new world.
Don't you dare close your eyes. Hold your breath, it gets better.
I'm like a shooting star. I've come so far. I can't go back to where I
A whole
used
new
to
world.
Every time I
with new horizons
every
to
moment,
pursue.
Red letter.
I'll chase red them anywhere. There's time to spare.
Thank you, Eric and Julie. First of all, I want to say thank you to Kathy Essenson, who's up there taping this. I see Tristan's up there, too. And it will be either on the church website or at the, what's that, WC?
WTCO.
WTCO. So they'll have on TV sometime, so hopefully you can watch it again. I want all the performers to stand up. All the performers stand up, and let's give them another round of applause.